When I was little, my Savta taught me that silence was a woman's best garment. But I have to admit, I never really took her advice to heart.
Hello everyone, welcome back to another video on Rainbow Six Siege. Playing this game feels so amazing, but for those who want to excel in their skill and reach the paramount, they need to focus on each and every detail, and for this we have brought you the Rainbow Six Siege Operator Guide. This is the first video in our series, so welcome back to the GDI channel. Lay back and enjoy, because in today's video, we bring you how to play Ashe in Rainbow Six Siege. You might be a pro or just a beginner, but this video is definitely going to help you. Before diving into the proper tips and techniques, we will discuss the background story, a bit of the biography to have that feel and connection with Ashe. Her real name is Eliza Cohen. She was born on December 24th in Israel and is 33 years old. Cohen's mom is a renowned Jewish political activist and a professor, while her Palestinian father is a professor of Middle Eastern studies. Cohen was raised in Israel, excelling in mathematics and physics. She earned a degree in structural engineering at Tel Aviv University and spent a few semesters at Boston University. After graduating, she joined the Israel Defense Services. Later, she moved to the US to work with FBI SWAT. Cohen applied her degree in engineering and gift in structural resistance to develop advanced demolition tactics and equipment. Along with Hebrew, Cohen is influenced in Arabic, English, French, and Greek. Ashe excels as a breacher and entry fragger. Her speed and breaching rounds make her well equipped to quickly and suddenly breach into a room and be ready for a fight. She can coordinate with teammates to expose important angles or roam the map as a lone wolf. Her weapon, namely the R4-C assault rifle, gives her an advantage in gunfights against most defenders. So now, let's begin with the main part. We will begin with the utilities. She has breaching rounds that are capable of breaching any soft breach from a distance. This is one of the facts that makes Ashe to be one of the most lovable operators in the game. Now, Ashe and Sophia have nearly the same utility, but Ashe is more faster, while Sophia can do different stunts and stuff. Ashe is a 3 speed, 1 armor, and 1 difficulty operator. Also, she is a better choice for long distance breaching. Now we will talk about weapons. The weapons Ashe possesses are the G36C and R4C as primary weapons. Both of these are assault rifles, and 5.7 USG and an M45 MEU SOC as secondary weapons, and both of them are handguns. Talking about primary weapons, R4C is the most powerful one, and a G36C is the most accurate one. It has an angled grip, so it helps them to scope in faster. It is up to you what you prefer more, power or accuracy. You can choose your gun according to that. The secondary pistols are almost the same, so there's not much choice what we got. And finally, for the gadgets, we have the breaching charge and the stun grenade. Her breaching rounds are best paired with stun grenades. Tossing 2 or 3 stun grenades into a breach room can effectively catch defenders off guard. Talking about the breaching round launcher, it can breach soft walls from a long distance. Her launcher is equipped with 2 breaching rounds. The range on the launcher is essentially unlimited. After penetrating the target surface, the breaching round will explode after around 2 seconds. In soft walls, the breaching round creates a hole similar to the size of a standard breaching charges. Now, to use Ashe, you have to be an entry fragger. For those who don't know what an entry fraggers are, an entry fragger's job is to go in first and get the crucial opening kill. A player that is classified as an entry fragger has a very good crosshair placement, recoil control, and generally is the most aggressive player on the team. Which means if you're playing as Ashe, you got to get kills for your team. Her utilities are not that much beneficial, as she is a gun dominant operator, so make sure you're rushing while playing Ashe. Also, don't play very slow. She is 3 out of 3 in rating when it comes to speed. You also need to be a very good team player and must know all the callouts, as you will most likely be rushing and leading your team in different locations in the game. In simple words, if you got good gun skills and are even interested in playing fast as an entry fragger and want to lead your team, then Ash is definitely the player to go for. Otherwise, there are a lot of other operators you can go for if you are a slow player and like to follow your teammates. What I've seen that many new players do is that they rush too fast and die without even calling out anything, or sometimes they're just too eager to get the kills. Yes, getting kills is an important part of the game, but you also have to play the main role as Ash, which is being a team player. Trust me on this. Try to build a better communication for your team while playing the game, and you will see massive improvements in your game. While Ash is a basic operator, you still need to remember some basic points. If you are playing the game at a competitive level, then you need to be the best skilled player, have the best aim, and be the best shooter as well. Now, we will talk about some advanced tips to remember while playing as Ash Operator. Ash's breaching rounds are highly useful for breaching soft walls, but they're also great for eliminating defender traps, though Ash needs to be accurately predict where they'll be. Breaching rounds have a fairly large explosive radius, so it doesn't have to be positioned very close to destroy Legion's gun mines, Ella's gizmo traps, Cap Kane's EDDs, Frost's welcome mats, Albi prism decoys, and more. If you know the defenders are employing traps like these, considering launching a breaching round near a doorframe or common choke points. Okay guys, so this is it for the video on how to play Ash in Rainbow Six Siege. We hope the video was informative as well as entertaining. Thank you so much for watching till the end. Do not forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel, Gaming Daily Input, for more videos like this and to keep yourself updated in the gaming world. Comment down below if you have any suggestions or requests. See you in the next video. Thank you.